DM7 Control provides additional keys, knobs, faders, and more to either size of DM7 console. And the broadcast package and the theater package are included with it. It's going to improve the user experience and speed up the workflow in most situations. So let's see how to get it connected and synchronized with the console. Firstly, make sure you have a power outlet available for it. If you wish for power redundancy, connect a Yamaha PA700 AC adapter or equivalent item recommended by Yamaha to the external DC input on the rear panel. Next, use a gigabit Ethernet cable to link the DM7 control with the DM7 or DM7 compact console. If you already have a network connection to the console, simply move it to the spare port of the DM7 control. The two ports are linked by an internal switch. This connection is IP-based, so it can be passed through external network switches, and the cable can be up to 100 meters long. Though in most cases, it makes sense to keep the DM7 control closer to the console. Anyway, the DM7 control is simply an incredibly useful controller. It does not include any additional audio processing. Before proceeding with the setup, it's important to check the console firmware. It needs to be version 1.5 or higher to be compatible with DM7 control. Open the setup menu and check the general screen. The current version is displayed in the center. If it requires an update, it's best to follow the official update guide. Though do note that when upgrading the console firmware to version 1.5 or newer, it includes the firmware for DM7 control. This portion of the firmware gets stored inside the console, ready for when the DM7 control gets connected. You don't need to load firmware separately into the DM7 control. Once the required firmware is installed in the console, the DM7 control can get connected and powered on. The default IP address settings of both devices are compatible with the same network address used. It's worth checking though in case something needs to be edited. Press and hold user-defined knobs 1 and 2 for a second to enter the control panel's menu. Press button 2 again and you'll be able to see the firmware version currently in the DM7 control. If it's different to the console firmware, it will be updated after synchronization. Rotate knob 2 to find the network settings and press knob 2 again to access them. Match the network settings to those of the console, making sure the last number of the IP address is unique. Open the console's setup menu and the network screen. Then touch for mixer control to see the console's network settings. If DHCP is selected, it will automatically ensure the settings are suitable. Then make sure DHCP is also selected for the DM7 control. If static IP is selected, make a note of the IP address used and use a similar number in the same subnet for the DM7 control. Back on the DM7 control, use knob 2 to enter the correct network mode and IP address information. For example, if the console has a static IP address of 192.168.0.2, then I can set the DM7 control to have a static IP address of 192.168.0.3. So long as nothing else on the network uses those addresses. Then use knob 1 to go back a level in the menu and find the connection setting. Press knob 2, then turn it to find the IP address of the connected console. DM7 Control will discover any connected DM7 console or consoles sharing the same network address. Select the one you want and push knob 2 again. Push knob 1 a couple of times to exit the menu and the units will synchronize. Now on the console, take a look at the DM7 control setup screen. At the top left, you'll see the status of the power supplies and you will see if firmware is being transferred. If that is the case, wait a few minutes for it to complete. DM7 control will also display the update status. Then it will automatically restart and synchronize, and it will be ready to use. In the DM7 control setup screen, you can program the four banks of user-defined keys on the raised panel, as well as the E and F banks of keys towards the front of the control panel. I like to use these for DAW transport controls, but there are many other options. You can also program the four user-defined knobs, perhaps for selected channel EQ or dynamics controls. The two faders can be used to control any channel, input, DCA or output, or the monitor and Q levels. The panner is not yet active with version 1.5. It will come soon with a future update. The scene, ink, deck keys can be used to simply scroll through the scene list or to actually recall the next or previous scenes. And the jog wheel can be used to scroll through the scene list quickly in case you don't need the DAW functions. Or use it for touch and turn, in which case you'll need to assign it to one of the bays, left or center, in the case of the larger DM7, which has two fader bays. Finally, select the controller mode. Sidecar is the usual mode when the DM7 control is expected to be attached, or at least very close, to the console. Then, the LED, LCD, panel, light and color settings are shared between the console and the control unit. Otherwise, select remote mode and the DM7 control will then use independent controls for its lights and displays found in its settings menu. Use knobs 1 and 2 to access that. So, there you have it. Enjoy the added ergonomics and versatility provided by DM7 Control. And don't miss my other videos about the included broadcast and theatre packages. They bring another level of capability to this already very well-equipped series of digital mixing consoles. Bye for now.